Alright guys, so remember I did a video a few days ago. I did a video of predicting every Chicago team's record and how they'll do in the next season. And you guys remember when I said I was going to do an Illinois one? Yes. And remember when I said I was going to do a whole NFL one? I ain't doing that. But today, we're just going to be doing... We're going to be predicting Illinois' 2022 season because their season starts before the Bears. So, we're going to be checking out Illinois' season, who they play. And now, my cat's going to join us. So, with that, let's get to it. A little recap on last year. We finished 5-7. And I think we made the playoffs, but lost in the first round. We were first round exits. Like always, all Chicago teams are just first round exits now. And we didn't really have good offense. Chase Brown, Williams, maybe Casey Washington was good. But other than that, we didn't have really good offense. Defense was good. Owen Carney, Isaiah Gay, Kirby Joseph, Devin Witherspoon, Sidney Brown. Oh, I'm so sorry. Those are the real team. That's the team that we all need. Alright? That's what got us to 5 wins and 7 losses. You may think 5-7 is hot garbage. I could say it's not as good. But if you really like take a look, I don't think. Some people will know. We're going to have to cut the video a little short, though. A little short. I'm joking. Let's get to the schedule. Starting off with the first team. Here's our schedule. So, our first game is against the Wyoming team. I don't know what their other name, but their Wyoming Horses or something. So we're just going to call it Wyoming. Wyoming. I don't know anything about Wyoming. But just looking at the standings, I think they're just decent. I think they're kind of where Illinois is, but a little better. I don't know anyone on Wyoming, but looking at their record, I think that they are like exactly where Illinois is. Maybe a little bit better, maybe a little bit worse. But I don't really know. Because like, Wyoming is that team where no one talks about. They're really underrated. I mean, they're better. They got more than 3 wins, 4 wins. You need at least 5 to 6 wins. Five or more wins to make the playoffs. And Illinois got 5 wins. So they were lucky to get there. But since we are at home against Wyoming, I will say that is a win. Because when we play at home in our first game, we tend to mainly win those. The last 3 years, Illinois has just won. Like, we won these games. I'm actually cooking pizza right now, so if you're in that little, it's the pizza in the oven. And to make sure I'm not lying, I'm going to be eating while the game is. But, I would say Illinois do win this game, though. I can see us winning this game. We're at home. It's a lot better. And, like, I just think it's easier for us to maintain a home field advantage for that one. So, I would say Illinois beats Wyoming. All right, for our next opponent, week 2, is against the Indiana Hoosiers. The Hoosiers. Hoosiers, however you say it. So it's the Oklahoma Sooners and then the Indiana Hoosiers. They look exactly the same. But Indiana really disappointed you last year. They only got like 3-4 wins. And comparing Indiana to Illinois, Most of these teams are in the same level as Illinois. But I think that Illinois has the potential. The thing that makes it tougher for Illinois to win this game is the fact that that Indiana is at home. And Illinois really isn't that good on the road. Yes, I get it. We beat Penn State, Minnesota, almost Iowa last year. I get it. But those were like garbage time, last second touchdowns. Mainly. Why don't you guys play the entire game? Not just the fourth quarter. I get it. Comeback kids, if you want to play the Falcons, then I guess. But really, you shouldn't really have a hard time in this game. And this is all coming up in like in August. So, still have a few more months. So, I'm saying that I'm predicting Illinois will win this game. I think that Illinois has a chance to stop them. And look, it probably just one bad year, and then they could come back and just, Indiana can just come back and just win. Win more games. So, I will say this is a win for Illinois. And I do not know the entire schedule, so this is why I have the little thing back there. I would have done it on my phone, a little split screen, but yeah. So, Illinois wins this. There's one here, too. Alright, so looking at the schedule, it seems to see that we are at home against the Virginia Cavaliers. Dude, remember if you watched all Illinois last year, which I personally watched all their games last year, watching that game sucked. It was terrible. In the beginning, it was sluggish. We tied it up with 14-14. And what does Virginia do? Touchdown, touchdown, touchdown. Beat us 42-14. Just absolutely killing us. And it gives us a little bit more competent, make us more competitive in this game because we're at home this time. And I think Illinois does tend to play better at home than they do on the road. But I have to say this is a loss. Virginia was good last year. I don't know what their record was. I just know that they were just that team. They were just that team. See what I mean by Alexa? Look at this. Boop! Yeah, it wasn't cooked all the way, so we had to do another 5 minutes. But it's still a loss, man. Virginia killed us last year. They probably will kill us again. It's just, I don't see Illinois. I can see Illinois being a little competitive. Maybe more competitive than last year, but I think Illinois can still lose. I'm sorry, but I think Illinois will still lose. Week 4, we are playing the Chattanooga team. Obviously, a few months ago, I made a video of the basketball team beating Chattanooga, if you remember. But now, this is football. And I think, I don't know how Chattanooga is in football. I think they're decent. I haven't watched any of their games, but I just see them being decent. I feel like Chattanooga is just decent. Like, their basketball, decent. Football, decent. And the fact that Illinois is at home, I do see Illinois taking care of them, taking us to 3-1. I just don't really see Chattanooga taking out Illinois like that. And Champaign, I see Illinois making at least like 20 points to like 17. I don't know. And I will not be doing a whole week by week of, if I do a whole week by week of college, that'll be like a whole hour long. Do you know how many teams are playing a day? 32 NFL teams. Compared to like 100. 100. Is she still awesome? Yeah, 100 or more college teams.
Dang, she's already moved to six.
Yeah. So I don't know, but I still think Illinois can win, though. It may not be like a blowout, but I can see Illinois like winning, like, at least, like, by 5 to 10 points. So, that's what I'm thinking. We got our first big hard one. Like, big. We're playing the Wisconsin Badgers. Last few years, Wisconsin has killed Illinois. 2020, 45 to nothing. Then last year, shut it out? No. You can't even be happy. And the fact that we're in Wisconsin. I'm sorry, Illini. I love y'all. I love my team. And I always crap on Wisconsin. I always crap on Iowa. But how do you see us winning? Unless it's like this, all their team is injured. We just have COVID, which I don't want that to happen. But like, the only way I see us winning is if we actually get a chance, if their best players are gone. But that's probably like a very low chance. So we're probably gonna lose this game. No, not probably. We're definitely losing this game. We're on the road in Wisconsin, which Wisconsin has like seven Big Ten titles every year. I'm sorry, bro. So that's like 3-2 now. There's no more explaining. We're losing this game. So we have two teams I was just talking about. Now we have the Iowa Stupid Hawkeyes. The Hawkeyes. Y'all know I hate Iowa, but I only like Iowa because of their colors. It's black and yellow, but if you're an Iowa fan or a Steelers fan, don't wear them in the summer. And if you have a big fear of bees, don't wear those. Don't wear the jerseys in the hot, because bees will come attracted to those. And they will go all over you, and you have no control, because bees love black and yellow. If you're just wearing black or you're just wearing yellow, they'll come to you. But if you're wearing black and yellow combined, that is just like, you don't even know what to do. So I put the piece in because like the thing was, it wasn't fully cooked enough. So it's like three more seconds.
Are you talking to somebody?
Video. Yeah, we're playing Iowa. I already know, this is a loss. I get it. Yes, we're at home, but do you just see it? Do you see any chance? You see a possibility of us winning? No, you don't. That's why I have to say it's a loss. And now we are tied 3-3. What will happen next in the season? Next up, we got the Minnesota Golden Gophers. Stupid name. Okay, we're at home and we really never beat Minnesota besides last year. That was somehow lucky, but we always get blown out by Minnesota. You see how red this is? I jammed my finger earlier on the second pass. But I say, if Illinois, depending on how Illinois is doing during the season and how Minnesota's doing, if Illinois is doing good then or decent, then I say maybe we can win. If Illinois is doing Nebraska Rutgers level and Minnesota's like Penn State, Clemson, Alabama, Georgia level, we're getting destroyed. We obviously beat them 14-6, but that was just one. That was one. I still sadly see us going below 500 at 3-4 because we cannot seem to win any games. Speaking of the devil, Nebraska, we are playing the Nebraska Cornhuskers. Nah. Nebraska is just terrible. All in all, bad. You can't really say they're good. They're not good. Coach sucks. Team sucks. Defense, offense, anything about Nebraska just sucks. Illinois beat them last year. They beat them 2020. I think 2019. Oh no, we reacted to a video about that. So we didn't win that. But seeing the last few games of Illinois winning those, I see Illinois winning. This time we're in Nebraska. A bunch of cornfields. That's what the Cornhuskers are for. I think that Illinois could pick it up and win that game. Nebraska ain't that good. I think Nebraska can beat teams like Northwestern, maybe Rutgers, but that's basically it. if they beat, they can beat teams that are their level, but teams that are above Nebraska's level, no. And I think Illinois is above Nebraska's level. So Illinois will win this game, go to 4-4 evenly. Okay, so next we got the Michigan State Spartans. You see, they're like Mustangs or Spartans, always the name. We are at home against Michigan, and I do not see us winning. Dude, Michigan State is decent. We beat them in a last second touchdown, but I don't see it for this game. I don't see it. I don't see us taking care of Michigan State. The fact that we're at home makes it worse. It would have been a lot worse if we were on the road, but they gave us, cut us a little slack and made us at home because Illinois is better at home than they are on the road. So, I will give us the dubs. No. The L. I'll give us the L. And just got a notification the Sox are playing. Yeah. I don't know what the score is right now, but probably losing to the Yankees. Because we are losing to the Yankees. I don't know. Here's the score. Shockless. I'm just speechless. But I really want to see how Illinois does. I want to see what Illinois does. And mainly this is all just a painting of how Illinois does in the season. And how the other teams are doing. It's mainly all just depends on that. But I will see, based on last year, Illinois losing this game. Illinois losing this. So they're at like 4-5. All right, so we got a winnable game. Purdue Boilermakers. We can lose, but then it seems like we can win. We are at home. And I really, again, like, when Illinois is at home, that's when we can win a lot more games. I feel like Illinois is better off at home, winning games at home, than they are on the road. That's just my prediction. I could be totally wrong, but who knows. But looking at it from last year, Illinois did lose to them last year, but Purdue was okay. I wouldn't say they're elite level, but they're decent, serviceable level where they could win you a game or at least make the playoffs. That's it. I don't see them being contenders in anything, and I don't see them being a crap level. That's just what I see. I could be completely wrong, but I don't know.
I was doing a prediction video, and now she took the remote. So I'll just make the prediction out here. So I was just looking at the schedule. So first we were playing, I can see us beating Purdue. So that's like 5-5. So that's even. I wanted to go outside, so yeah. Then the last two games are on the road. Michigan and Northwestern. Michigan, we're getting killed. How do you expect us to win Michigan? We're at Michigan. The best team in Big Ten. And you're going to see us winning that? Comparing us to them? No. Actually, I'm not going to do this. But yeah, we're really outside, bro. Oh. But, Illinois is just not going to win. That's all I have to say. We're not winning this. I can see us getting blowout. I don't think it's just a normal loss. This is going to be a terrible blowout. It's not going to be that Illinois can upset them. No, we're not upsetting no one. We're not winning this game. We're officially at 5-6. Very last game of the season, we're playing the Northwestern Wildcats at Northwestern. We've killed Northwestern every single year. That's not true. We lost the last few years. But we killed them the last season, which got us in the first place. So, I'm thankful that we actually beat them. And luckily got us in. So, basing on this game, I'm seeing Illinois win. So, last year, 5-7. This year, 6-6. One more, but we're in the playoffs, so barely in. All right, barely. That's my prediction. So, what do you guys think? Good, reasonable, or not?
Well, Zeta made me carry the phone